So here's the real kicker. We spent quite a bit of time now on showing you how to compute the inverse of a matrix. And what I'm going to do now is convince you that you never should. Well, you shouldn't unless the matrix is small. Now, that doesn't mean that we wasted our time, because in looking at Gauss-Jordan, you reinforced your understanding of how Gaussian elimination and LU factorization works. You became more familiar with Gauss transforms, etc., etc., and it reinforced your understanding of what the inverse of a matrix is. So this has all been important for learning about linear algebra more deeply. But the fact is that in practice, people don't invert matrices to solve AX equals B. And let me show you why. So throughout, let's assume that A is an n by n matrix. And let's look at what it costs to solve AX equals B via LU factorization or via Gaussian elimination, which we discussed before. Well, you have to factor matrix A, that's 2/3 n cubed floating point operations, and then you solve a lower triangular system, and you solve an upper triangular system, and therefore the total cost is given right here, 2/3 n cubed plus 2 n squared. If you do by first inverting matrix A and then multiplying, what happens? Well, you invert matrix A, that's 3 times as expensive as performing an LU factorization. Now, after that, you still perform as many floating point operations in multiplying the inverse matrix times the vector as you would if you performed a lower triangular solve followed by an upper triangular solve. So you don't really gain much. So the bottom line is, it is much cheaper to first factor A into L and U, and to then solve with the triangular systems as new right-hand sides come along. So, usually you do not invert a matrix. If someone talks about inverting a matrix, you should be very suspicious. Back in the 1970s, a very important package called LINPACK came out, and that was the first software package that was widely used for solving problems related to linear systems of equations. When they did a study of what the most frequently used operation was in that library, it was the operation for computing the inverse of a matrix. Why? Because when people wanted to solve AX equals B, they would call the routine that inverted the matrix and then perform a matrix vector multiply. And we just argued that that's much more expensive than it needs to be. So when later a new package came along called LAPACK that replaced LINPACK, what they actually did is they didn't include a routine for inverting a matrix. They kind of made it difficult to do that. And that was in great part to prevent people from doing something they shouldn't be doing. They should be calling a lower triangular solve followed by an upper triangular solve after performing an LU factorization. Now, some people use the term inverting a matrix interchangeably with solving AX equals B. Particularly engineers often talk about inverting a matrix when they really mean that they want to solve a linear system. So then they are not really specifying that they explicitly invert the matrix. They're merely saying, I need to solve this linear system. So don't be too critical of such people. Just ask them for clarification. Now, these comments do not apply for small matrices. Sometimes it may be useful to actually explicitly invert a small matrix. And it turns out that if you first invert a matrix and then you multiply, there's sometimes a problem with something called numerical stability. Sometimes you may not get a high quality solution then because of round-off error that sneaks in when you perform the computation. But that's a different course. That's typically covered in a course on numerical linear algebra. And there are exceptions. So if you look at the next unit, you will find out that I, as your instructor, who has just proclaimed that you should never, ever, ever invert a matrix, I actually wrote journal papers on how to invert matrices. And this was for very special cases where the inverse of the matrix actually was needed. So, don't be too critical if people talk about inverting a matrix, but be very suspicious.